Hello, everybody. Today I'm going to talk about persuasive influence and your ability to be cool under pressure. The ability to be cool under pressure is not easy, so don't think that it's something that people just learn right away. You have to have experiences. So have I. Of course, my first mentor was my mom right there behind me, and this one is called Don't Shoot the TV. All of a sudden, her boyfriend comes in the room, and he is furious. He's got the shotgun out. He's like, that's it. There's nothing on television. I'm going to shoot this TV. My three brothers and I were thinking, oh my God, this guy is going to shoot the TV. Eric, Todd, Chuck, and myself, we were totally enthralled with what was going on. My mom walked in the room, and she displayed the three traits that you have to have during a persuasive influence situation. The first thing she did was she understood the scenario. Second thing she did was she spoke with reason and with calm. And third, she talked the aggressor off the cliff. So when we talk about understanding the scenario, what do we mean? What we mean is what is going on in the situation and with the individual. So the way my mom understood the scenario, she looked at him and she said, you know, if you shoot this television, the kids won't have anything else to watch. You good with that? And then number two, she said, what example would this show? When they get mad, they're going to want to lash out and do things like shoot a television. And then number three, she simply asked him, can you afford a new one? So when she was giving these tips, hints, words, we were thinking, this is not going well for getting the TV shot, because we were all in for it. And then number two, she spoke with reason. Now, when I talk about speaking with reason, what do you do? I'll tell you what she did. Her tone was very important. She spoke really calm. And then her volume dropped. She starts speaking softer and softer and softer. The third thing when you talk about speaking with reason is your pace. Her pace slowed down. She didn't get agitated. She just spoke really slow and really calm. And when she did that, you could see the whole situation de-escalate. The third thing she had to do was talk the aggressor off the cliff. Now, when you're in a situation, it may not be easy to talk your aggressor off the cliff because they went on the cliff, so that's where they want to be. But it's necessary if you want to diffuse the situation. So how does she do that? She gave him a clear way out. She said, hey, we have another TV in the other room. You can channel surf. You can do whatever you need to do. I'm sure there's something on, or we can play some music, you know, listen to the radio, do other things. She gave him a way out. Number two, she acknowledged his frustration. She said, you know what? We pay all this money for cable and there's nothing on TV. I agree with you 100%. But if you shoot it, there definitely will be nothing on TV. And then the third thing she did was she distracted him from his unrealistic thought process. And what she did, the way she did that was she talked about how things went at work, what was going on, is he going to go fishing soon, certain things like that. And as she was talking to him, you could see he started getting distracted and everything kept calming down, calming down, calming down. So needless to say, things didn't go the way we thought we wanted them to go. She used the three traits. Trait number one, she understood the scenario. Trait number two, she spoke with reason. And trait number three, she talked the aggressor off the cliff. When you're in your scenarios and when you're dealing with people, you have to remember those traits. So the question you have now is, what happened? He did not shoot the television. Eric, Todd, Chuck, and myself, we were disappointed. We left, we went to the backyard and started playing. All of a sudden he comes out, he's got his head down, he's not happy, and he says, come here, kids. So we came to him, he says, hey, I apologize. I know I was going to shoot that television, and if I did, there would have been nothing for you guys to watch, and it was a bad example. Are we cool? I said, yes, we're cool. My brother Todd said, sure, dude, we're cool. And my little brother Chuck said, fine with me. My older brother Eric, he's always the one who nails every situation with his words. And he looked at my mom's boyfriend. He shook his hand and he said, yes, we're fine. But if you would have shot that television, we would have been cool with that too. That sounded, it really looked like something good to see. He smiled. We all laughed and smiled. And that was it. So remember, whenever you're dealing with somebody and you're trying to de-escalate a situation, remember the three steps. You got this. And whatever you do, do not shoot that TV. See you later, everybody.